Listen, I know that things are going to continue exactly as the Bible says they will until Jesus comes back. And listen, there's going to be real global warming in the tribulation period. Let me tell you, it's going to get hot, especially by the time you get to Revelation chapter 16 and the bowl judgments. But we are being lied to and manipulated, and these globalists are using these things to manipulate the masses of people. That's what's going on. They're the ones that are promoting the misinformation. And then consider this. You think about controlling the masses of people. We've been talking about this for a long time. You look at the current lockdown situation that's still going on in many parts of the world, and the more and more restrictions that are coming because of mandates and so forth, controlling the masses of people. Now we have the climate laws, by the way, that are going to be extremely aggressive, and they're just going to be oppressive to the people. Controlling where we're going to live, what we're going to eat. What in the world's really going on? Listen, they're telling us one thing. They're telling us we got to fix the climate. They're telling us we got to have lockdowns. Everybody's going to die because of a virus. They're telling us you can't go shopping without an ID. They're telling us all these other things. Listen, things are far worse than what they're telling us because of what they're not telling us. They're telling us this while they're doing that. They're not telling us the truth. The truth is, this is about control. This is about the government controlling the masses of humanity and their attempt to build a utopian world. I want you to think of these words as we wrap this up. In Psalm 2, the psalmist writes, "Why do the nations rage and the people plot a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves together, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bonds in pieces and cast away their cords from us." What do we have here? A picture of the last days when the rulers, the merchants, the great men of the earth, the politicians of the earth, the ones, the Klaus Schwabs of the earth, they meet, they plan together. They meet at the UN building. They meet in Washington, D.C. They meet over in Glasgow, Scotland. They're the ones who fly the jets that you're not allowed to fly in. These take counsel together. And what's their counsel? Let's remove the Lord from us. Let's cast off his cords, his restraints. No, we're going to build a utopian world. This is what they are doing. It is far worse and far, far, far further along than what almost anybody actually realizes. This is what they are doing. But there is great news. Their kingdom is not going to last very long. The Bible tells us that kingdom of theirs is going to last at the most, 7 years, and the Lord is going to rock it. And Psalm 2 goes on and says, "He who sits in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall hold them in derision. He shall speak to them in his wrath and distress them in his deep displeasure. Yet I have set my king on my holy hill of Zion." God says, "You guys are going to do this? You're going to mess with me? Listen, you try to get rid of me? No, 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 no. This is my world. And you're trying to remove me from this, and you have oppressed my people, and you're going after them, and you're trying to create your utopian world where you're going to destroy this place. It isn't going to happen." God says, "I'll hold them in derision, and I will set my king." Jesus is coming back. He will rule and reign from Jerusalem exactly as the Bible says that he will. In the last days, Romans chapter 1 tells us that what's going to happen. The people of the world are going to worship the creation. They're going to take this planet. They're going to lift it up and say, "There is your God. Now bow down and worship it. Pay your taxes to it. Support it. You're going to come under these laws." God says, "Not so fast. I am the king. You want to worship the creation rather than the creator? This is how it's all going to go down." Jesus is coming back. Listen, as we watch what's happening right now, these globalists, these elitists, they are not going to let the gas pedal off. They're going to keep pressing harder and harder and harder and harder and harder. That's what they're going to do. They're not going to let this thing go. They're going to tighten up that noose. They're going to put the squeeze on us. We need to be prepared. We need to be wise. And the best thing that we can do is know that the Bible told us things were going to go this way during the last days. If you understand this, if you look to the Word, listen, I would not perish. I would have perished if I did not have hope in your word. I would have been destroyed. Also, Jesus said in Luke chapter 21, men's hearts will fail them from the fear of what is coming upon the planet. Listen, you don't need to be afraid. When you are afraid, you are easily manipulated. Listen, don't be afraid. Things are happening exactly the way the Bible said it would. And know that even in this, even in the climate nonsense, these climate laws that these people are bringing about to control the masses, because that's what it is. Even in that, it is a massive sign that Jesus is about ready to call us home. Listen, things are happening just like the Bible says they would. But the most important thing with all of the prophecies that are in the Bible, the most important thing is that Jesus came the first time. He himself says, the Bible tells us, Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I prepare a place for you, I will come back to receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And then he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody comes to the Father except by me. Jesus says, I prepared this place called heaven. I prepared it for you, but I am the only way, the truth, the life. He doesn't say I'm a way, a truth, a life. I am the way. You must come there by me. I built it. It's my home. I want to bring you there, but you got to trust in me. The Bible also tells us there's no other name under heaven by which we can be forgiven than that of the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen, if you don't know that you're going to heaven, you don't know that you are forgiven, you're a forgiven person, then ask Christ to forgive you, surrender to him, repent, turn from your sin, ask him to forgive you. The things that are happening in the world right now, listen, you can look at the Bible and go, wow, Jesus told us it was going to be this way. The prophets of old told us it was going to be this way. We need to be ready. And if you're solid in the word, you're going to be strong in your faith. You're going to find great encouragement. If you're not, you're going to be fearful right now. Listen, Jesus loves you. Listen, I want to encourage you to go to my social, go to my Instagram, Tom Hughes Prophecy. Check it out. Also, my website, hopeforourtimes.com.